club soda. Some bombs never go off, some stars never blow up. I'm pitching in, never in the dugout. Reaching in my and I can't take a head count. Flashback, 03, things was looking run down. Now I set foot in the place, it's a luau. Killing like 10 counts, y'all know how we get down. House with the fence around, y'all know that we in route. Transition from the Impala to the Fisker. I should charge admission for that to get the dessert. Left the doors up, now the Lambo has pigtails. Since you getting comfy, I'ma let you sit there. I'ma let you stay there. When I brought some, cause you say you want sick. If you love sick in the room, you best get well. Every dog has his day. What the no tuck? Quay Lee went to magazine, double XL. Floss with your Gucci on. Dipped in colors burst on the cars and the jewels. Like they got a spray tan. When I was without, not a helping hand. I got some guys that throw it back and make me drop the cans. I told Ben Frank just to drop a pin. I could let my fit go to the highest bid. Yes, I might drop in. It all depends. Junior high, I was dreaming of a 10. I'm coming clean, though. I mean, not a spec. My girl be serving looks. I be the chef. Katana sword popping out my walking cane. I'm overseas, my Cali Bay like how was Spain. We getting to the money and you having issues. I bought a and it came with a wetsuit. The Buddha. I'm mooching off myself. She be hoping that I take a knee. Yes, I be open to that shrimp life. This is how we live, this is how we exist. Love the kicks and we love the hits. All in the house and I'm wrecking. If I sleep, I'm a wrecking. I'm in my own world, throw the money up and make my own weather. Mommy playing, tether on leather. Money talk, it's a lecture. 80 pointers dance on me, it's electric. Don't hate, I'm still unaffected. Chip on my shoulder, I move undetected. She said, pop the question, the question got deflected. Man, I'm in my board, then my brethren. Let's cut to the chase. It's only on the house when we in the place. My used to lava boys got it up in some flames. Stirring up the cup with my wrist souffle. Shaka Zulu chains with my name engraved. I told you on swing, don't say my name in vain. To your door like, you rang? Spending all the money, then we watch it boomerang. With the Fendi belt, angry face like, put some gold on my fingers, neck, and shoestrings. Long time, no see, that's what they say when they see me, man. I've been going crazy just to stay sane. Hey, your girl went missing, who's to blame? Young whippersnapper with a range. Pause, then I went deranged. Call that hottie on my stage. Long week, but a great day. So it's got me.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a matchup today where the focus will be on the passing game. The 49ers are top 10 at defending the pass, and they'll be going up against the Lions, who will need to solve that secondary.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the home of Super Bowl 50, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the San Francisco 49ers. From nearby Stanford, Christian McCaffrey. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Second down following the run.
Hurry up, here we go. Hey.
Gone.
Over.
He'll drop to throw. He's going to go for a big play down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And a return across midfield into the 46-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. First carry for Samaje Perine. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8.
Over. All right, here we go.
He'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Agnew. And now look at him go. 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Lions.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's OSCE. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say OSCE.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
And it's up and good. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken at the 3. Solid return. Pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
They start on the ground with Perine, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Run.
9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down.
All right, here we go.
The slot man in motion right. They'll look to throw here. Escaping the pressure right. A good decision in the end to pull it and run. Gets him 9 yards and a first.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket. Got to the sticks and picked up the first down.
This one just across midfield to the 49. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. This is Ware, and he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third and one. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. In motion, James, the tight end. They'll run it now out of the gun. It goes as a gain of six, and it's a first down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
They'll set up a throw. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And here comes play number six on this drive. Now a carry for Piron. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
The best defensive lineman, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
A first look at the NFL scoreboard comes from down in Arizona. And early on, the driver's seat belongs to the Seahawks. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. They'll run again with Piron. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down.
Kidd had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. They're going to look to throw. Flush to his right. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Well, that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. The 49ers are going to turn over to the special teams crew. The field goal unit is out there now. And his kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they were able to move the ball into the red zone, but they'll wind up coming away with just three.
Yeah, 32-yarder. That's equal to an extra point nowadays, and those are no problem for an NFL kicker.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So out now come the Lions. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Three.
The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Throw left side complete. It's Cannon. He got 29 yards that time.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, as the Lions are in possession of the football here to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Back to throw here. His throw incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll drop the throw. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
First down, this is McCaffrey looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Over the middle, complete. That's Cannon. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. A couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And his kick is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. most of them want it end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Now a play fake here on first down. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Vic Beasley in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking for Snead, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills, and his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? McCaffrey. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Second down, McCaffrey with a first down and more, and he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. A great effort there, his fifth touchdown now on the year, and the Lions add on to their lead. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. It's P. Ryan to begin the drive. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
If they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive.
They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And that's complete to Jesse James. A good pickup there, a 22. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And now a first down following that long gain. Now P. Ryan. Room to run inside the 40. And he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
To play here in the first half. Back with more after this. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, that run wasn't very successful. They did have a big one on the previous play. So you get the sense that the offense is probing around, trying to find the ones that are going to work. And when they find them, they'll keep coming back to them.
Intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Give it up to McCaffrey. And an alley to run. Past the 20. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great play there with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21 points. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do.
Here we go now. Hey, hey, hey. Three, all right, now, look at 56.
The drive starts with a handoff to Piron. He finds an opening past the 40. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Being chased out left, and he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Meanwhile, down in Glendale, and early on, the driver's seat belongs to the Seahawks. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
On play action, they'll throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They go play action here on first down. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And they'll send the slot in motion left. He'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Willie Snead, as the first half is winding down. And the 49ers get a score closer. And this is up and good. That'll make it a score now of 24-10. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Elsewhere, a score update from New Orleans. And it's the NFC champs, the Falcons, that have moved down to an early advantage. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. Start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he's got Rome. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Looking to throw. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. They only needed a few inches there on second, but forget the halfback dive. They were going for the big one.
I thought it was a good time to take a shot. You figure their running game, if they don't get it there, you come back and run for it and pick up the first down. Go ahead and be aggressive. Try and get one downfield for a big one.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Lions taking the lead to the break. As we send you cross-country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando with our halftime report, here's Larry Ridley. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken at his 4. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
and I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too, and they're scripting something.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jamal Agnew. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So we get a look at the Lions offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? As they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Handoff, McCaffrey running right, and he is knocked down from the side. At 5 yards on the play there, as the drive will continue.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Got a man right side. It's McCaffrey. Fights through and now a crease. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A gain of 32 that time.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Stay on the ground. McCaffrey again, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on 3rd down. This is McCaffrey on the give. And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Here we go now.
Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
I'd say the staff that's up in the booth watching the game, they may want to file that one away. See how fast the free safety closed to make that play? Might want to check into a throw the next time.
Well, Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Here's McCaffrey pushing through the contact. Yeah, he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it brings forth a third and long. The Lions on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 14. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and that'll push the lead up to 17. So put another 3 on the board, and all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the third quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. It's complete to Snead. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Now back to throw. James has got it. Complete. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
So the offense has it first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go.
Back to throw. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
For many teams, the evaluation of tight ends has really changed. We used to wonder about how they would block first and foremost. Now we want to know how these guys can run, because we envision them in offenses, catch the ball. How much yardage can they gain after that?
And that on display there for a good pickup. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's 49er football, but some ground to cover. They find themselves behind as we hit the fourth and final quarter. to throw now on second and 10. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. Leppard.
He'll drop to throw. And oh, they almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the 10. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so they can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down.
Second down following the run. Shift together here from the D-line. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Reed. A good pick up there, a 22.
That's just his second catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. And they've done a great job of doing that.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Here's Pirine. And he'll take this one down to the 36. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
He'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
So he can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know. But you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 7.
All right, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
play fake. He'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. They're already slim. Hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down.
Hurry up, here we go.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Reed. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. His throw caught at about the five, and he'll be out of bounds. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
They'll go to Perine trying to pound it in, and he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great effort there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
The Lions on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and four. This is McCaffrey. And an alley to run. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
With McCaffrey, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of two, now third down. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. The Lions on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 11.
Here we go now. 3-19. Detroit. Set. Boom, landed. Boom. Detroit.
They'll set up a throw. And this one is incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So it's 3 more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the 3 whenever you can.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's 2nd and 10. Again, here's Piran, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation. Here's Ryan Quigley now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. They'll set up to throw. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. Well, not only did they try to fake it, they put the ball in the arm of their punter, and it didn't work out.
Not the quarterback.
No.
The punter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Risky.
And it's so funny because when it works, genius. When it doesn't work, not so smart.
Not so genius.
In this case, not so genius, but I do admire that he went for it.
Touchdown, Detroit! A great play there with his 3rd touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead. I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door and maybe get back to base and feel a little bit better as you end a ball game that's been a frustrating one for you.
Yeah, we'll see if they go back to base. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Now a play fake here on first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's caught inside the 20. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. A big play there for the Niners. 57 yards. And this looks to probably be the final play. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot.
A lot there. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Lions, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1. And they'll have another road date next week with the New York Giants. Meanwhile, for the 49ers, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans against the Saints. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Santa Clara.